Hey all, welcome back. We are in the 21st video of this Flutter series. So in this video, we're going to play with the form and we can see how we can validate with the given data from the user. If you do remember, in our past videos, we already discussed about the text fields. And now we are going to see how we can work with the text form fields. If you ask me what the difference between a text field and a text form field, the simple answer is, if you want to validate your function, then you can use a text form field. Like simple definition, if you need to validate the user input, use a text form field. That's the simplest definition. We'll see it with a small example. So let's start it. I have begun my application, my project with by creating a sample Flutter project. So in that, let me create a form. So I have a form widget here. So inside the form widget, so I want everything in a column wise. So I have created a column. So inside column, I have a list of children, which is a list. So in that, let me write a first text form field. So inside a text form field, so we have a property called validator. We'll see what is this validator. I'll pass here a value. And okay, let me stop autosave here. So what this validator will do? So we already told you, right, the text form fields, if you want to validate something on the text form fields, so you can use a validator here. Now to use a validate function, we use this validator. So validator is a property which holds a value, and we'll see how we can do a validation here. So the first thing, so the value is the one that we enter text inside a data that we check for the validation. Here we will see the entered text. It might be an empty, or if you want something which is greater than some characters. So if you want to validate those, we will write some function here. First thing I'll write here, the value is empty. So what I'll do, I'll write some if condition here. I'll write username cannot be empty. And my next condition is, else if value dot length, which is less than 5, less than or equals to 5, then again I need to print write a condition here, text or the username should be greater than 5 characters, right? Username should be greater than 5 characters. So this is what I want to validate it. This is a text at the time of doing a validation. If I don't have any other condition, I'll simply write a null condition here. So return null. Okay, so I'm done with the creating a first form field. Okay, so next I'll create one more button. So when you tap on that button will validate. So we'll validate and it will tell whether this form has a proper data or not. That particular text field will say. So next we want to create a small button here. That button will validate this. So we'll see how we can do that. So let me create a small sample flat button here. So inside this flat button, I will just give it as a name as. So okay, we'll create a login function. So think like we are creating a login function that will add two text form fields and once login button, I'll give it a name as a login here. So for that, I'll create a child and inside the property, I'll write the text as login. Okay, this is my first, and I'll give it some color. So I want to give some background color as blue, and I want to give a text color. Color stroke point, and I'll create some on press property here. Okay, done. So let's see. Let me run this. Okay, you can see I have created a form field and as well as a login button. So let's create a property. Let's create a validate function. So I have to create a validate function. To create a validate function, what you need to do is to use this validate function in the form, you need to associate a global key. that global key in this form widget. So we can create a global key. First go to the top and create, go here and create a one final variable here and give it a name as key. Assign this to a and create one global key, assign this to our key, and inside this pass a type. So our type is form state. So now we have a global key that was associated kept inside a key. Now come to this onPress method and come here. So what it will do, so when if the condition satisfies this, so we will show one print dialog, print here, like some success statement here. If the condition doesn't satisfy, then you can see how it's validated there. So we'll see it by passing. We can inside this, I can write a condition: if key dot current state dot validate. If the validation is success, then print statement. What I'll do here? Condition satisfied, so it is success. So we'll see. So let me open my console. Okay, I have opened my console. So the first thing, so we'll write the satisfied condition here, right? I'll write some one to write my name money and control. So I have written. Okay, we have created a global key, but that key we have not assigned anywhere. So let's go inside the form and we have a property called key, and then just pass the global key that was created. So now go here and let me validate this. If everything is like if the condition satisfies this, in the debug console I'll get a success message. So we'll see that. So went here and I tapped on login. See, now I got a success message. So this is because of like this condition was satisfied, like in the form field my text is not empty and as well as my text is not less than 5. So we will see by passing means we will dissatisfy the condition and we will see. So the first thing I will enter text less than 5 and I click login. Can you see the second one is executed? The username should be greater than 5 characters. So next I am just removing everything and I return here. Now it is saying like username cannot be empty. Okay, these two conditions got validated. This two conditions are validated here and we have seen it. So we will add some more stuff for this. We will add some more stuff to this and we'll create one more text field here. So this is text field. So let's see by creating one more text field, which is a password. So let's assume the first text field is a username and the second one is a for a password. So what I'll do in the same manner, I'll write here password cannot be empty and so password should be greater than 8. Okay, less than, if this is 8, so what I mean password cannot be empty and as well as password should be greater than 8. Okay, this is for the second text field. And as well as we have one more property for the text field, which is called obscure text. So this will automatically give security to your text. Like in the text fields, when you're entering the data, right, you can see some stars or some kind of invisible data, right, that will place on the text field. The same, if you want to do the same thing, you can do it by passing an obscure is a other text. So now you can see there are two text fields here, and we will give some padding this, as this is not really looking good. So we will give some padding. Go to this form and give some padding here, wrap with padding. So and I want to give padding as 60 from all the sides. 16 is not looking good, so let me give 32 here. See, now we can see I have got some padding here, and also and I have a login button here. So now what it needs to do, when if I enter the data which is not proper, like based on these conditions, now this both text fields will work. We'll see it now. So we have seen the first one, now we'll go to the second one and we will check here. So here if I give some, see, sorry, here I need to give pass true, so then only it will, the obscure text is true, then only and save it. Now we can see now we got secure text. So now I've entered here, it is saying that password should be greater than 8 characters. So if I don't write anything here, so if I write something here, like Manikanta, I wrote here, and I don't write anything here, the first condition was satisfied. That's the reason you don't see any validation issues there. Second condition, like second text field, the validation, it is showing in the the issues with the second condition. It is showing the, see, the first in the first text field, it has properly passed because the validation condition got satisfied, and in the second text field, it is not passed properly because it has failed at some one validation, which is that text is empty. If I enter as like this, and again, this now there's a second condition, it's got, it's not passed because we should ask expecting a characters which is greater than 8. So again, we'll see. So now we can say password should be greater than 8 characters. Okay, this is how you can do a validation with a simple text form fields. So based on your requirements, whether you want to use a simple text, you can go for that normal text field. If you want to do some validation with the text, then you can go for the form field, like you can go with this form widget, text form field widgets.